Good morning, students. Welcome back to Zoology webinars of Model School for Senior Inter. In the previous session of the Zoology, we discussed about human anatomy and physiology of human reproduction. In that, Prashanthi Madam and Satish Sir explained us about female reproductive system, male reproductive system, and also about the gametogenesis, fertilization, embryo development, and lactation. Till there, we have discussed. Now, let us learn more about the reproductive health. Now, in this regard, so why we have to learn this? See, you know, like, what is the population of India? It is more in the world. It is the second largest populated country, isn't it? So, if we won't control all these measures, like population rate, we may surpass China, where, like, you all know India, like, recently lockdown also, how the people suffered, isn't it? Because of more population. And the government cannot give each and everyone all the benefits because of this large population. So we have to control our population. So we'll also learn in this reproductive health about the control of the population. That is why the population explosion is there in India, and what are the birth control measures, and suppose if infertility is there, how to overcome the infertilities, all those stuff, even surrogacy methods, isn't it? If suppose the new technologies are there, genetically, if suppose if we have hereditary or any diseases, that can be detected before the birth of the baby. So all those technologies also we learn today. And children, please take a book. As I told, always tell you, please write down all the notes, important points, so that it will be useful for IPE as well as for the competitive exams. Okay, today we have with us Satish Sir from Asifabad and from Komaram Bhim district. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, ma'am.
Sir, please take over the session, sir.
Okay, good morning, ma'am. I welcome you all for the today's webinar session. And I would like to express my profuse thanks to Srimati Vijay Lakshmi ma'am, DSMS Narsapur Medak as our coordinator, and Srimati Shailaja ma'am Garu, the webinar team head. Now, I would like to explain the reproductive system, fourth part, in which the reproductive health or sexual health of the individual can be discussed today. Children, today's topic is reproductive health. Reproductive health is nothing but it is the sexual health of an individual. The definition is given by WHO as well as per our textbook, the definition is like this: having healthy reproductive organs with normal functioning. In simple terms, the definition is given, having healthy reproductive organs with normal functioning. That is only the reproductive health. After knowing this, what is the need of reproductive health? Need for reproductive health, prevention of STDs. What is meant by STDs, children? STDs are nothing but sexually transmitted diseases. Prevention of STDs. After knowing the knowledge over the reproductive health, we can prevent the STDs also, and the birth control measures and its need also to be discussed in this chapter. Children, reproductive health means having healthy reproductive organs with normal functioning. As per WHO, World Health Organization, the World Health Organization also given a comprehensive definition here. The definition of World Health Organization is like this, children. Take the notebook and write down. This may be asked in NEET examination or any competitive examination, children. WHO defines the reproductive health is a state of complete well-being of individuals. The state of complete well-being of individuals. In what manner? In physical, in functional, in emotional, in behavioral, in social aspects of reproductive health. This is the complete well-being with all these following punctualities. That means individual should be physically well-being, functionally well-being, emotionally, behaviorally, and in social aspects also, the individual has to complete well-being. That means this is the comprehensive definition, children. World Health Organization given the comprehensive definition for it. After knowing this, you may be able to know the need and significance of sexual health and prevention of STDs, birth control measures, infertility, population explosion, assisted reproductive technologies. These are otherwise called as ARTs, children. ART, assisted reproductive technologies, and new methods also there for the surrogacy methods are the new technique used for non-having children to the parents. Worldwide, the map shows that the yellow color part of the map is totally spread with the sexually transmitted diseases overall the world. That means if we don't have knowledge over the sexual health or the reproductive health, we may easily contaminate the diseases from the others. Actually, 2000 per year, 20 million people are suffering from reproductive health diseases. As per this, we have to know, as we were discussed about the human reproductive system, male and female, earlier classes, the male and female, both the reproductive organs, primary sex organs are actually in the male. Testes are the primary reproductive organs, and the ovaries are there in human female. Ovaries are the primary sex organs. We have to know what are the primary sex organs and what are the secondary sex organs and what are the secondary sexual characters. We already known, but we have to recap it once. Children, the male and female parts, the learners are also, in our learners, male and female are there. We have to know, every male and female individual children has to know about these primary and secondary sexual organs and its health also. Human reproductive system contains not only about these two diagrams. It is about sexual health of the individual. Nowadays, government also started some programs like Janani Suraksha Yojana, reproductive child health, and reproductive child health care programs. In India, actually, maternal mortality rate, infant mortality rate are high in India. What is the need for reproductive health? Here we have to discuss it, children. It remains the leading cause to death and disease in the people of reproductive age, 15 to 24 years. This is the reproductive age, children. Actually, maternal mortality rate and infant mortality rate are high. Mortality rate means death rate, children. Infants, the early born, newborn children, newborn kids are died due to knowledge, not having the knowledge over the deliveries and the reproductive health also, and not properly using the medicine also, check and health checkups. Spread of STDs still a major problem, children. Sexually transmitted diseases is a major problem. 2 million people live with HIV or AIDS in India. As we know, children, HIV is a dangerous disease. HIV is nothing but human immunoviral disease, virus. So it is a virus disease. Some virus, bacteria, and some protozoans also causing these health diseases, these STDs, children. As WHO told before, as the population is increasing, we are experiencing the population explosion. That's why it has given some quotations, we do, us too. We parents too, and we have children too here. That means we too, us too indicates in previous days. But as the population is increasing, in China, only V1, V1 or none policy has been introduced in China. That may be introduced in our India also, because we are in second top in population is concerned. Approximately 1.30 crores of population as per the census 2011 census, it was there like that. Now in top, in next coming 5 years, we may get first rank, even if we won't control the this. Children, say our generation that stop killing female fetus. Here, we kill and we destroy the female fetus, because after many advanced techniques has come, it has become a violent explosion that we are killing female feticides. If female is not there, the equilibrium or the balance in society may be lost. That's why we don't have to kill the females. Female feticide is to be banned. And as per this need for reproductive health, 2 million people living with HIV AIDS in India. AIDS is a dangerous disease here. It is very hazardous to the people, but HIV virus is a causative agent for it. What's meant by AIDS children? Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Yeah. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome is the full form for it. The immunity power of the individual must be lost whenever the HIV changes into, it is modified into AIDS. HIV is different, children. AIDS is different. So HIV changes to the AIDS, then only the victim is totally suffering from AIDS disease. Government has taken many action plans on reproductive health. Actually, to attain total reproductive health as a social goal, the government has taken total reproductive health as a social goal, children. The family planning programs are initiated in 1951. That means for 70 years before it was initiated, even though it is going on slowly. Some reproductive, RCH is nothing but reproductive and child care health programs also introduced by the government. And massive child immunization in the sense, as you know, children, polio vaccine is giving to the children at the age group of 0 to 5 years now, children. Like that, massive child immunization is going on. And supply of nutritional food to pregnant women, as Anganwadis are giving now. Anganwadis are supplying eggs and everything, the nutritional food also supplying by the Anganwadis, by the Union Government of our India. And one more program also launched by our Union Government is Janani Suraksha Yojana. The institutional deliveries should be conducted in these children. This is also an action plan taken by our government, Janani Suraksha Yojana, JSY. Then creating awareness by the government. Totally, government is creating many awareness programs, and not only the government, non-government agencies also taking a step, children, to educate the people. This is the action plan that government has introduced. STDs. We have to concentrate more on STDs. STDs such as HIV, AIDS to the adolescent age group. Actually, adolescent age group people, they don't know, and they're very, the people can suffer from not having knowledge over the adolescent age about these reproductive parts. That's why they may contact each other with their attraction, and they may be the victims of these STDs. And fertile groups, marriageable age group, they may easily acquire these STDs easily. For birth control options also needed to population explosion is a major cause, major cause nowadays, children. That's why we have to control the birth, for which the birth control measures are to be known. Postnatal care of mother, newborn child is important, and breastfeeding also important, children. The awareness program on this reproductive health, especially proper information about the reproductive organs to adolescent agencies, hygienic sexual practices and safe sex, we have to know the knowledge over this, children. If we don't have knowledge and hygienic sexual practices, automatically we acquire, easily we can acquire these STDs, with which whatever the conception or the whatever the fetus developed in the mother's womb, it may also affect with the STDs, and the it is very dangerous to the both mother and the newborn child also. Now, I would like to concentrate on the STDs, children. STDs are nothing but sexually transmitted diseases. These are otherwise called as venereal diseases and also called as renal tract infections. Reproductive tract infections is nothing but infections through intercourse or sexual contact. Sexual contact infections are nothing but the STDs. The STDs, many more types of STDs are there here, children. First one is gonorrhea. Gonorrhea is a disease. Syphilis is a disease. Genital herpes, it is also a disease. And genital warts. Genital herpes, genital warts. Genitalia should be clean, children. Always we have to maintain some hygienic environment to the genital, external and internal environment of the reproductive organs. Cervical cancer is nothing but the cervix is there, as you have learned about the uterus. The starting part of the uterus is called as cervix, where the vagina ends. That may lead to the cervical cancer in female. Trichomoniasis, it is also a disease caused by the protozoan parasite. Chlamydiasis, bacterial infection. Hepatitis B virus, and HIV infections are AIDS. All these infections, gonorrhea, syphilis, genital herpes, genital warts, cervical cancer, trichomoniasis, chlamydiasis, hepatitis B, and HIV infections, all these are with bacteria, virus, and some protozoan, children. That means bacteria, virus, and protozoans, these are the minute and microscopic organisms. We can't able to see even, but they are causing danger to the human being, children, in both male and female. Actually, what are the causative agents for these means? The causative agents for the chlamydiasis is Chlamydia trachomatis. Here, common sexually transmitted diseases that can lead to the blindness, Chlamydia trachomatis, blindness, not with eye disease, children. Blindness may come by birth or by eye diseases. If we met with an accident to the eyes, automatically we lose our eyes. With that, the blindness may come. But with RTIs, this is very much dangerous, children. With this reproductive tract infection, by this chlamydiasis disease, we lose our sight also. We may affect with blindness. What a dangerous, children. That's why we need reproductive health is essential. Next one, spirochetes. Here, spirochetes, most of the members of these species, Treponema pallidum is a spirochete bacteria. This is the causative agent for syphilis. And one more, cyanobacteria is also there, and gram-positive bacteria is also there, children. Bacillus clostridium, like gram-positive bacteria, may cause these reproductive tract infections, children. Causative organisms are there for here. There here, those are bacteria, virus, and protozoans are there here. Neisseria gonorrhea is a bacterial disease, children. Treponema pallidum is a spirochete bacterium. As I shown, in red color are bacterial, in black color are virus, in blue color in Trichomonas vaginalis is a blue color one. This is a protozoan one. Protozoan parasite also causes this Trichomonas vaginalis in human female. The causative organisms are like this, children. Bacterial, viral, and protozoal diseases. First of all, we have to concentrate on viral diseases. Viral diseases, HSV, herpes simplex virus, HPV, human papilloma virus. You have to know these words, children. Abbreviations also to be noted. Take the notebook and write down this. Concentrate on these. This may be asked in 2 marks questions. What is HSV and what is HPV and what is HBV? In which some are curable diseases and some are non-curable diseases. That means HSV, HPV, HBV, non-curable. Non-curable is hepatitis B, HIV. HIV, human immunodeficiency syndrome, children. This is mostly non-curable. Actually, female may live up to one year to 7 years, but male may cannot survive because female have more immunity power than that of a male. HIV is a dangerous virus, children. Next, birth control measures, children. Birth control is also known as a contraception and fertility control is a method or device is used to prevent the pregnancy, children, here. Birth control methods are there here. What is meant by birth control? From times, birth control methods are using in safe methods. It is became available in 20th century also. They are planning, making available and using birth controls by family planning methods. Family planning is nothing but it is a birth control option, children. Birth control is also known as a contraception and fertility control is a method or device used to prevent this. Birth control need methods. To overcome the problem of population explosion, birth control is the only available solution, children. According to the census of 2011, population growth rate is 1.64%. Such a high growth rate lead to the scarcity of food, shelter, and clothing. As the population is increasing, we can't be able to get the food, shelter, even clothing also. That's why it became a major problem, children. Increased healthcare facilities along with the better living condition had an explosive impact on population growth. Okay, if we are aware about these increased healthcare facilities, also it became a problem, children. Next, statutory raise of marriageable age of 18 years in female, 21 in male. Actually, do you know the marriage age, children? Okay, as per government, whenever you become major after attaining 18 years, but in male, they become major when he is attaining 18 years of age, but the marriage is different. But in female, 18 years are the marriageable age decided by the government. As in the male, it is decided 21 years, children. Why the marriageable age is decided by the government means in the ancient days, early marriages were done. Early marriages, child marriages. Due to child marriages, the child is growing, her reproductive parts and body growth is not yet completed also. They did marriages and they underwent many reproductive health problems, children, after getting married. Whenever they attain the 14 years of age only, they become mothers. That's why they may acquire some large loss. Birth control methods are there, children, here. The birth control methods are of these types. Actually, contraception is there. Contraception is nothing but intentional prevention of conception by natural or artificial means. intentionally we are privating. That means we don't know whether it is conceived or not. If it is conceived, we have to use the contraception. Contraceptives here. Contraceptives are nothing but prevent pregnancy interfering with normal process of ovulation. Prevent pregnancy by interfering the normal process of ovulation. That's why we are using contraceptive methods and contraceptives are used. These are of 7 type children here. Contraceptive methods are natural methods are there, barrier methods, intrauterine devices, oral contraceptive pills, OCPs, contraceptive injections, drug-releasing implants, vaginal rings, skin patches, and surgical methods, vasectomy and tubectomy. These, one by one, we have to discuss here, children. Actually, the natural methods are of 3 types, children: periodic abstinence, coitus interruptus or withdrawal, lactational amenorrhea. First of all, we have to discuss about the periodic abstinence, children. Periodic abstinence is nothing but 10 to 17 days from the menstrual cycle, non-participation in coitus, periodic abstinence. That means what is the, actually in 28 days of the periodic cycle or menstrual cycle, from the 10th day to 7th day, there may be a possibility of ovulation. Ova may be released from the mother's ovary. That's why if those days, those are the 98% releasing choice is there. That's why we have to, the periodic abstinence is followed, non-participation in coitus, that may be a natural method to prevent the conception, to prevent having the pregnancy. And coitus interruptus, when the coitus is nothing but it is copulation of both male and female after getting married. You will be known, children, the coitus is nothing but coitus interruptus while ejaculating the sperm into vagina, withdrawing the penetrated penis of male from it. That means the ejaculation of semen or sperm cells are entering into the vagina. Whenever the leaving sensation received from the male penis, then only the individual has to withdraw his penis from its vagina. That is called, this phenomena is called as coitus interruptus. And third one is lactational amenorrhea. Lactational amenorrhea, while the ovulation is not done while lactation period after delivery, after parturition of the baby, lactation may start. Whenever the lactation is there, the ovulation may not be done. But sometime that may be possible. But it is a natural method. Whenever the mother is feeding to the child, the ovulation may not be done. It is not 100% children, but natural methods we are following to birth control. Next, barrier methods also there. Here, male condoms and female condoms are the barrier methods. These are the hindrance. These are the male condoms, children. These are the female condoms. This diagram is there in our textbook. These are barrier methods. Barrier contraceptives are devices that attempt to prevent pregnancy by physically preventing sperm from entering the uterus. That means these barriers, if those are where by the genitalia of the male and female, automatically they may disturb or they may prevent pregnancy by physically preventing sperm from entering to the uterus. They include, as we discussed, the male condoms and female condoms, cervical caps are there, diaphragms are there, and contraceptive sponges with spermicides also there. Here, these are the barriers globally, out of which most commonly using barrier method is condom, children. Here, think about the contraception. Why contraception is required? you have to think over contraception to prevent the population explosion. Contraception is required. As we were discussing the natural methods here, how many types of natural methods here? There are three types are there here. In naturally, periodic abstinence from 10 to 17 days children. Coitus interruption while ejaculating the penis to be withdrawn. What is lactational amenorrhea? Period of breastfeeding time. This is also a natural method children, lactational amenorrhea. And the barrier methods, as we were discussed, male condoms and female condoms are there in this. And intrauterine devices is the third method children. These are otherwise called as IUDs. Intrauterine devices. A device is inserted into the uterus of the mother's womb. Uterus or the mother's womb. Those are also named like lip piece loop, copper T and copper 7, multi-load 375, progestoside LNG 20. Those are the different names, children. Those may be the physical apparatus that can be inserted into the mother's womb. That's why those are calling as intrauterine devices. These are also called as IUCDs, intrauterine contraceptives. Intrauterine contraceptives, ICDs or IUCDs, or coils. It's a small, often T-shaped birth control device that is inserted to the uterus to prevent pregnancy. The birth control methods are nothing but to prevent the pregnancy. The usage is done, children. IUDs are one form of long-acting reversible birth control. IUD means intrauterine device, children. Example, copper T. This is a 1.5 inch. It is approximately 1.26 in inches or 32 millimeter device is there here. This is to be inserted through the vagina up to the uterus. Automatically with this, the sperm cannot enter and the sperm entry is protected by this copper T, intrauterine device. Next method in birth control are oral contraceptive pills. Oral contraceptive pills, orally some tablets has to be taken. In contraception, orally progestogens, not progesterone children, progestogen. Progesterone is a hormone, no? Yeah, here progestogen is oral contraceptive pill. Progestogen, estrogen combination pills or tablets are to be used for birth control measures, children. How many days it has to be used? A married couple can use these OCPs daily, one from the first to fifth day of the menstrual cycle to 21st days. That means first fifth day to 21st days, they have to take one pill that's with which the ovulation can be stopped. The pills inhibit ovulation, implantation, retard quality of sperms. That means these pills have the power to kill the sperm cells, to protect or to inhibit the ovulation process from the ovary, and implantation also they can inhibit. And the quality of the sperm cells, these are the pills today, on which also the day is mentioned on the tablets also, children. These are oral contraceptive pills. It is also a method of birth control. Next, contraceptive injections also there. The contraceptive injections, drugs releasing implant, vaginal rings, skin patches. These are also birth control measures. The injection is called DPMA, dipartmetroxyprogesterone estate, DPMA. It is used as a contraceptive injection. It protects the pregnancy up to 3 months only, children. So DPMA is an injection also to be taken. This is also a contraceptive injection. And implants are there. Implants are nothing but These are the single masticoid rod-like structures. Those are also implanted under the skin, though those may also useful as a birth control device. And lastly, we have to go through the surgical methods. Surgical methods are nothing but two types are there here, children. As we know, in the female reproductive system and male reproductive system, we are discussing about these surgical procedures. Some small incision can be taken, and it has a cut, a small cut is a tight cut and tight. This diagram is there. This is nothing but vasectomy. Vasectomy is a family planning operation that may be done to the male children. Vas difference is cut and tied here. That's why vasectomy operation, surgical procedure, has to be initiated into the male. Here you see the diagrammatic representation, children. Testis is there here. The oval shaped one is testis, where sperm is producing. The producer sperm is this coil shaped epididymis is there, from which it is stored and it is sent to the vas deferens. The vas deferens is taken here, a cut, children. Due to this cut, it can be prevented. The sperm cells comes here and stop here. Only the semen and the prostate secretion is only going in the coitus, children. That's why this vasectomy operation can be used in males, especially in males, and it prevents the birth control. That's why it is a kind of family birth control measure. And in female, we know that the family planning procedure, tubectomy, is seen here. This is the reproductive part of this is the uterus, this is vagina, this is cervix region. These are ovaries, children. Ovaries are producing ova, fallopian tubes, into the fallopian tubes. These are the fimbriae, from which it is going here. And the fertilization here, it may occur the fertilization in the fallopian tube itself. If we cut these tubes, automatically the fertilization may not occur. That is a tubectomy process. That's why fallopian tubes, either side of the uterus, these to be cut. A surgical procedure was taken here. And due to this, we can prevent the fertilization procedures. Here, sometimes after the fertilized zygote, it may be implanted in the uterus, in the endometrium of the uterine walls. But here, fertilization without implantation also, some tubal pregnancy may be seen in these tubes only. Ectopic pregnancy. Ectopic pregnancy is a very dangerous pregnancy, children. The mother may affect more abdominal pain whenever the implantation is not properly done. The ectopic pregnancy is also observed in some cases. That this is due to the ectopic pregnancy also due to not having knowledge over the reproductive health. Here we are seeing this surgical diagram, children. Fallopian tubes are there here. This is the uterus. These are the fallopian tubes. The white color ovary is there. Thereby, the surgical methods, whenever we are doing surgery to this, automatically, at that time only, females are females are making surgery whenever they are doing cesarean. This is a kind of cesarean operation here. If fallopian tubes are cutting by using these tools to control another birth. This is also a procedure. This is a tubectomy process. And one more term is required here, medical termination of pregnancy. Why the pregnancy is to be terminated? In 1971, an act has come, children, here. The medical termination of pregnancy is legalized, because induced abortions are there here. Government made an act in 1971, it has legalized. Why the medical termination of pregnancy is needed? To avoid misuse, administrative machinery can keep a check on illegal female feticides. Most of the female feticides, due to control the female feticide, this act has been developed by the government children. The only available choice to get rid of unwanted pregnancies resulted due to casual unprotected intercourse. Unprotected intercourse also, the individuals are suffering from all this, and they're getting this kind of all reproductive tract infections, and failure of contraceptive using during coitus or rapes in case of confirmed curable genetic disorders in the fetus. The medical termination of pregnancy is required whenever these cases are observed. In these conditions, continuation of pregnancy is harmful. Whenever the rape is seen in the society, automatically it is unwanted. It is not to be continued. It is very harmful to the individual. That's why medical termination of pregnancy has been introduced and legalized. There are many advanced technologies has come, children. Amniocentesis is a procedure in which amniotic fluid is removed from the uterus, testing for treatment. The amniotic fluid, amnion, chorion, and allantois, placenta are the layers around the fetus, as we were discussed in the gametogenesis. Prashanti ma'am also explained you. Amniocentesis is nothing but collection of this amniotic fluid that is there now. Amniotic fluid is the fluid that surrounds, protects the baby during pregnancy. If amniotic fluid is less, the fetus may not survive in the mother's womb. That's why we have to maintain the amniotic fluid in a constant manner. The amniocentesis is a diagnostic procedure. This fluid consists of fetal cells and various proteins. You see here the diagrammatic representation. Here, this is the mother's womb here. Ovum is there here. This is procedure. As per this, amniocentesis procedure may be done like this. Next, infertility. Infertility is nothing but it is a biological inability of a person to contribute conception. Some parents there does not have children. Those are infertile. Not only the male parent, female parents may also become infertile due to their reproductive health. Infertility is nothing but biological inability of a person to contribute conception. Not to blame females. Always it is going on in this male-dominant society that female, if the female, the children, if she is not conceiving after getting married after 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, automatically their parents are the parents from the male side are abusing this female. That is not correct. Actually, both the couple has to be tested, then automatically the problems may be seen in both male and female. That's why the reasons for infertility are either maybe physical, genetic, or certain diseases, drugs, certain immunological or even psychological diseases also may be causing for this infertility. In India, female partners are often blamed for not conceiving in childless couple. But in many cases, the problem lies with the male partners. As I explained now, children, the male partners also become infertile due to not having this either physical or genetical certain diseases of drugs. Most of the people, they may take drugs, especially male people may take many more drugs. That's why that may lead to the infertility also. This is the major cause for infertility. Next, what is amniocentesis? As we were discussed here now, as per this, as the World Health Organization is given the procedure here, amniocentesis is a procedure performed usually the beginning of pregnancy to examine a baby's chromosomes. Chromosomes means how many chromosomes are present in human male and female? Very good, 46. 46 chromosomes. If one chromosome is less, what happens, children? Some abnormalities. Yeah. Abnormalities like some syndromic activities. That means 45 Turner syndrome, 47 Klinefelter syndrome. Yes. During this procedure, amniotic fluid is removed for testing. cells within the amniotic fluid are examined in the lab to test special fetal disorders. Especially, this test is done for specific fetal disorders. Specific fetal disorders are there. If specific fetal disorders, we need a medical termination of pregnancy. The entire amniocentesis appointment lasts approximately 45 minutes. In 45 minutes, the diagnosis procedure may be completed through the ultrasound examinations. There are some assisted reproductive technologies, children. Assisted reproductive technologies, ARTs. ART. Some techniques are employed in ART are IVF. IVF means in vitro fertilization, and embryo transfer, ET, or test tube baby. This is test tube baby. In vitro fertilization, the sperm, fertilization of ovum sperm done outside the baby of a woman is called in vitro fertilization, children. Zygote intrafallopian transfer, GIFT, Z-I-F-T, zygote. After, what is meant by zygote? Zygote is nothing but combination of or a union of gametes, both male and female. Those are outside the mother's womb. The zygote intrafallopian tube transfer. Directly the zygote fertilization takes place outside and it should be inserted into the fallopian tube. This is also assisted reproductive technology here. Reproductive technology. By using this and the gamete intrafallopian transfer, GIFT. It is a gift for child does not having childless couple also go for gift plan. This GIFT, gamete intrafallopian transfer. Some women cannot produce ova either due defect or diseases of the ovaries, still provide suitable environment for fertilization for further development. Actually, GIFT is the case where the gamete is transferred. And intracytoplasmic sperm injection is also a kind of assisted reproductive technology. And ART, artificial insemination is also a procedure, children. Artificial insemination, this is also a procedure. And in vitro fertilization, IVF, is a process of fertilization where egg is combined with sperm outside the body. In vitro means in glass. Outside the body, in vitro, this is an assisted reproductive technology, not natural here. For infertile people, the childless people, we are using this IVF technology as an assisted technology to conceive. The process involves monitoring, stimulating a woman's ovulatory process, reviewing an ovum or egg or eggs from the woman's ovaries, letting sperms fertilize them in a liquid in a laboratory. After fertilized egg, zygote undergoes embryo culture for 2 to 6 days. It is implanted the same another woman's uterus with intention of establishing a successful pregnancy. For those childless couple, the IVF technology is utilized after the zygote is directly implanted in the other mother's womb also. This is in vitro fertilization. Directly, these are the zygote. The zygote already entered into the mother's womb through the cervix. Automatically, it is implanted the zygote cells. In vitro fertilization process. What is GIFT? Zygote intrafallopian transfer is an infertility treatment used when blockage in the fallopian tubes. If some people, they may affect with the fallopian tubal blocks due to ectopic pregnancy or so, for which in the fallopian tubes prevents the normal binding of sperm to the egg. The egg cells are removed from the woman's ovaries and in vitro fertilized. So, in vitro fertilization takes place the GIFT technology is used. Resulting, the zygote is placed into the fallopian tube by use of the laparoscopy technologies. Laparoscopy is a kind of medical technology. By making small incisions on the abdomen, automatically the procedure can be completed, not cutting the skin completely. You see here, children, zygote is there. Zygote is nothing but here two cells are fused here, one and two fusing here. The zygote is formed. This is diploid in condition. This is 2N stage. After getting the zygote is cleaved, the cells are forming like this, 8-cell stage. Two cells divided into four cells, four into 8-cell stage. Then again cleavage. In the 8-celled zygote is again divided into many more cells. These are uncountable. Blastula in prospection. This ball-shaped shells, marula and blastula is the second stage, and the gastula is the third stage, as we were discussed in gametogenesis. Blastula forms the gastula here. There the blastopore is seen. The gastular cross-section is there here. Gastrulation. Gastrulation is the process from marula to gastula. The development of zygote, these cells are seen after the gastrulation is completed. The fetus is formed. Zygote is undergoing to the cleavage from two cells to four to 8 cells. Then cleavage continues and remaining new cells are formed. The germinal layers, everything layer. These layers, these cells, the multicellular tissue is forming organogenesis, everything to the fetus. Then GIFT, just we were discussed about the GIFT, ZIFT. Now GIFT, GIFT is a gift for childless couple. Gamete intrafallopian transfer. Here we were discussed about this. Uses multiple eggs collected from the ovaries. The eggs are placed in a thin flexible tube. Thin flexible tube. The gametes, both eggs and sperm. Eggs and sperms are injected into the fallopian tubes using a surgical procedure called laparoscopy here. Then you see the diagrammatic explanation here, children. We are collecting the ova from these ovaries here. Two ovaries are there. Collecting the ovaries by using these devices and transferring into in vitro culture. The in vitro culturized in the test tube, it is cultured. The zygote is there. It is cleaving four stages. And it is inserted after it is directly inserted and implanted to this uterus. Then artificial insemination is also a process of fertility treatment to deliver sperm directly to the cervix or uterus in the hopes of getting pregnant. Those who want pregnancy, automatically the semen is collected from the donor or the healthy male. Sometimes the sperms are washed or prepared to increase likelihood a woman will get pregnant. Artificial insemination is a process by which you see artificial insemination process here. Automatically sperm in sterile medium, it is there. It is taken and it is taken to the syringe and it is introduced into the uterus by keeping the such type of devices into the vaginal passage, and it is inserted. This is intrauterine insemination. Next one, intracytoplasmic sperm injection. In vitro fertilization IVF procedure, in vitro fertilization procedure in which single sperm cell is injected directly into the cytoplasm of egg. Here injecting sperm cell, this is sperm cell and egg cell. This technique is used in order to prepare gametes for the obtention of embryos that may be transferred to the maternal uterus. Next, this is nothing but this cleavage. Artificial insemination, intrauterine insemination, it is seen. And a new technique, children, surrogacy to the childless, In these instances where the women have problem in conceiving or providing suitable environment for the development of embryo in her uterus, the surrogacy method is suggested. Surrogacy, women have problems in conceiving, providing suitable environment to the development of embryo in her uterus. That means the childless mothers, the womb of the wife or donor and sperm of the husband or male donor are fertilizers, and the zygote is transferred to the mother, womb of surrogate mother. Surrogate mother is a special mother, in these two couples, the mother is affected with problems in conceiving. That's why we have to take another mother on rent. Only her uterus has to be taken on rent. They have to agree. If they agreed, automatically whatever the zygote through the in vitro fertilization is to be implanted in other mothers. That means surrogate mother is there. That surrogate mother can carry the zygote, the fetus, up to the day partition, 9 months. She has to carry, and after completion of the embryonic period is over, the childbirth is done. Automatically, she has to hand over the child, newborn baby, to the surrogate, those who are given the sperm and ovum to the earlier parents. That surrogate mother is different mother children. Here you see the diagrammatic representation is also there here. Types of surrogacy is traditional and gestational surrogacy is there. Surrogate techniques here. Gestational mother's husband, gestational mother and child, the father and wife. Here is a problem with this red color, mother, father's wife. And the ovum is collected from this wife, this mother, and this father. From father, the sperm is collected and the zygote is implanted in this surrogate gestational mother. She is not gestational mother. She is only the donor of ovum. He is the father. He is given the sperm. Due to the problem arised in this mother, automatically we have taken one rented mother here. This mother is called gestational mother. She can keep this zygote in this mother's womb only after 9 months. This type of contract is going on to this problem having mothers. That is called gestational surrogacy. Here, these two have the real parents, but they were donated. They were kept their zygote in this surrogate mother. This is a new technique developed here. This is legalized. On this, we have to go through the NEET and MCED patterns here. Ectopic pregnancies are referred as implantation of defective embryo in the uterus. There are another here choices we have to go through. The test tube baby program employs which one of the following techniques, children? Actually, we have aware of all these ICSA, GIFT and IUA and GIFT out there. Here, test tube baby program employs with zygote intrafallopian transfer, GIFT. The permissible use of technique for amniocentesis is detecting any genetic abnormality of the fetus. Is the right answer for this? The technique called gamete intrafallopian, GIFT it is recommended for those females who cannot produce the ovum. GIFT is there. GIFT process, an ART procedure. Next one, at which stage HIV infection does one usually show symptoms of AIDS? When HIV damages large number of helper T lymphocytes, it is needed, children. What is medical termination of pregnancy? Consider safe how many weeks of pregnancy here. Answer is 12 weeks, children. Whenever 12 weeks the embryo is consisting, the medical termination of pregnancy is required. 12 weeks is right answer. Which of the following is not a sexually transmitted disease?
Hello. Hello. Sir, can you hear me? Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for a very informative session. Children, please revisit again and make a note of all the points and do prepare for the IP exams. Thank you, children.